DHCP is essential in most networks. We might have a dedicated DHCP server at a large office, but smaller offices can benefit from a DHCP server running on a local router or switch. And that's exactly what we're looking at here, running DHCP server or a DHCP relay on a switch. For this video, we're going to use the topology shown here. There are a few workstations connected to a switch and a router that they should be using as their default gateway. For the first part, we're going to configure the switch as a DHCP server. Later on, we'll convert the switch to a DHCP relay, which forwards requests to the server on the right. As you've no doubt noticed already, older Junos switches have slightly different commands to the newer ones. Juniper changed things up so they can keep things consistent across all their platforms. And DHCP is no exception. There is a legacy configuration and an extended configuration. The associated lab allows you to try them both out. It's likely that you'll see both in the real world, so as we go through this video, I'll try to show you both sets of commands side by side. The extended config requires a bit of pre-work to get started. The first thing we need is a layer 3 interface. The simplest option is to map an IP to a VLAN on an IRB interface, but you can use a physical interface if you want to. Lastly, we need to enable the DHCP server on the interface we just created. This includes creating a group for identification. If we have multiple subnets that we want to use DHCP for, we might create multiple groups. Now we can work on the DHCP pool. I think this is kind of self-explanatory, but basically we define the network that we're using and then start and ending IPs of the pool. Notice that the extended configuration requires us to give the IP range a name. Next, we work on configuring attributes. The first attribute that we want to add is the IP address of the router that the workstations will use as their default gateway. The next attribute is the DNS servers. The config varies quite wildly between legacy and extended. We should also check out that our config is working. On the left, we have a switch with legacy DHCP configuration. On the right is extended configuration. For legacy config, Show System Services DHCP binding shows us the current leases. If we try legacy commands on a switch with extended config, they will tell us that DHCP is not running, which can be a confusing error. Anyway, the extended version of this command is show DHCP server binding. Sorry, I'm just having some trouble typing this command. There we go, I had two of the keywords back to front. Anyway, you'll notice that the output is slightly different. In either case, we can add the detail keyword to the end of the command to get more information. For some advanced troubleshooting, we can look at the DHCP server statistics. That will show us the various DHCP messages that this switch has seen and whether it's responded. We can change our perspective a bit and look at our switch as a DHCP relay rather than a DHCP server. This will pass DHCP requests onto the server over on the right. Step 1, you need an IP address, such as a VLAN or IRB interface, as we saw earlier. Next, we need to configure the IP of the server that we're forwarding the bootp messages to, and the interface we're using. In the same location, we also need to configure the interface that we're forwarding this with. And that's it. Much easier. We can still get some useful troubleshooting info with show helper statistics. A very short quiz this time, still worth your effort if you can spare a few minutes. And that's how we configure a DHCP server or DHCP relay on a switch or router. That's the end of part 1 of the video series. In part 2, we're going deep into Juniper configuration, starting with the active and candidate configuration files. Click the video here to continue the journey.